Hey everybody, welcome back to Nerdvana Reactions. I'm Anna, and today we are checking out Avi Kaplan Behind the Dream, Parts 1 through 4, as the first part of my Avi birthday feature. If you enjoy the video, please like, comment, and subscribe. My Cash App link is in the description below if you want to support the channel, and let's go ahead and get into this.
All of my songs are truly from my heart. So I think the idea of choosing ones that we feel like the public is gonna like or even love, like that's the goal, you know? Like, my music isn't just for me. Like, it's not just for us. I mean, if anything, for me, I believe it's more for other people. So if I'm gonna sit down and put an album together, you know, with someone as amazing as this, like I want to take the opportunity to give people what they want, you know?
Is he gonna make me cry? I think the answer is yes, probably. He's just so sweet. Also, if there's weirdly placed pauses in my speech, it's because I'm fighting off hiccups. And the fact that I'm a little teary-eyed already probably is not going to help that.
No.
Do you want to hear the ending?
I think I like the ending of that one that he's got highlighted.
I can't decide. I love that one.
Oh, yeah, right. So, like, I did really feel like there was a magic where there was, we were both kind of thinking of it in different ways, mm-hmm. popular music style mm-hmm. way. But on the other hand, we were both, like, encouraging each other to remain cinematic and esoteric and kind of spaced out.
True to yourselves. That's always the best option. That's exactly what we want to see and hear.
The energy that we're putting across on it, like, just even the texture that we're trying to project to the world and that we're trying to do, just that we're trying to accomplish, was so important. Yeah. And I feel like that in itself, like, just making sure that we get things that really matter to us. Yeah. And not just about, like, oh, what do we think is going to sell? It had to be like, what is the most beautiful thing that we can create right now?
Right.
You know, like, truly, what is going to serve this song to the fullest extent?
Yes.
You know, if it was about the song and it was about the album as a whole, like, how do we bring these eclectic songs together and, like, make them feel like a big home, but just
special.
Different rooms?
I haven't seen his solo version for All Is Well. I've only seen the version he did with Joy Williams, I think was her name. But Avi has yet to write a single song that I don't find hauntingly beautiful.
All is well.
Part 2. If I'd been smart, I would have stuck these in a playlist so I didn't have to keep changing tabs. Not that smart.
When you have a group of people that have so many influences, like, everyone's pretty self, you know, controlling on, like, mm-hmm. what you do, and there's so many different influences that it kind of doesn't become an issue if you're but again, you have a really unique palette which really these guys all responded to in a
way. Dude, it was such a cool way that they, like, just grafted into it, you know. And I also feel like, just talking about, you know, the question before, like, there are so many things in just what I like to do that are such, like, small fragments of other things. There's so many things in there that I feel like it couldn't possibly feel like anything that has come before.
A little extra magic today.
I'll say equal magic to all the other magic things. How about that?
Everyone set up these fence posts of musical, like, ideas, the mm-hmm. kind of, you know, all of those and the CSNY and the these little things, and everyone was kind of reacting to that fence we drew that was, like, super esoteric.
like I said before, like his taste, like in everything, like in food, like in art, in what he's reading, what he's listening to, what he's wearing. Art and music is about taste. Like that's all there is when it comes to it. You know what I mean? It's like, just because I think something is awesome doesn't mean he's gonna think it's awesome.
That's definitely a really strong point. And one that I've come into contact with a lot since starting this channel, because I've had a lot of experiences where I'm kind of pulled outside of my normal wheelhouse, which is more for popular music. I don't know, 80s and 90s, some 2000s boy bands. But for the channel, I started this channel on a cappella and people who used to be, in Avi's case. And I've worked my way into so many different genres that I didn't initially think would appeal to me, and had initially excluded based on preconceived notions. And I'm very thankful to have broadened my horizons like that. And not everything I watch is to my taste, but when it comes down to it, someone enjoys anything that's up on YouTube. There is someone who will enjoy it. And sometimes we may not reach as many people as we want to, other times we may reach way more than we expect. And just getting that sense of connection with the people that we do reach, and to all of you watching, that's something very special, because having that similar sense of taste, and in a lot of cases being drawn from the same, like, how Avi has rooted a lot of his solo work in folk music. I listened to so much folk, like Seals and Crofts, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, just pretty much anything that classed as folk in that era, I listened to. Not in that era, because I wasn't alive yet, but on cassette in the car when I was a kid. And it's a very emotional type of music that I think invites that sort of connection, because everything's out there, everything's on the line. You're not holding back, you're not worried about how it's going to be perceived. You are putting your soul into the music and looking for that sense of connection with the people who can understand it. And it's, yeah, I'm gonna stop now before I do start crying.
And just because he thinks this is at a certain level doesn't mean I'm gonna think the same thing. You know, it's like the taste has to match up. And in some ways, like, you know, I guess it could be like it's just musically. But I feel like with us, I feel like it's more than that, you know, like so many things lined up. And I think that just helped us to bond and to trust each other musically.
I went to his house. Man, this guy is like a true connoisseur of the arts. Like, it doesn't matter. It's like whiskey, it's music, it's, you know, in moments, like enhancements. It's all these things. And I was like, this is a dude who has a wide, beautiful palette. There's like nine shades of blue to every blue. There's like nine shades of fucking black. You know what I mean? That's the sauce.
I think that, I mean, he knows, I'm like so particular, and there are certain things like in demos, like when the songs were written, that I was like, oh man, we have to keep this, we have to keep this. So the guys would play those things that I really, really loved, but anything else, like, it was freedom for the guys to do and play. They're such good players. Like, Shooter got these guys, and not only are they good players, but they're such good hearts, you know what I mean? And you could feel that between everybody that was playing together, and that is something that's so unbelievably important to me, and is obviously important to him because he surrounds himself with people like that. And to just have all these really, really, like, sweethearted people together and, like, making this music.
And I know I wasn't right, don't be mistaken. I'll tell the truth when I'm a fool.
The reality is, you have that kind of smarts. So everybody here is there to serve the song and the visions. And there's moments where I'm like, hey, can we do this thing? And you're like, yes, if you want to do it, I'll do it.
That kind of flexibility is just amazing to see, because collaborating with other people, whether it's something as simple as a project in school or working with your coworkers or something as big as a creative endeavor like music, the more moving parts there are, i.e. people in this case, the more ways there are that things can go wrong. And to have that flexibility means you're saying, okay, it's not going to go wrong. It's going to go how you want to try it. And having that ability to just kind of riff, especially in a creative project, has got to be one of the key elements of how to actually keep a semi-large number of people working well together.
It's not what I thought, but the other way, and what was so good about this crew.
And they were just such good players.
Yeah, I remember when we adapted the drum set, like right off the bat, it was too rock and roll.
Yeah.
So we changed, and they brought David and Jamie brought that resonator kick drum out there, and they just started becoming more cinematic.
So good.
But we still had the Terry Reid rock and roll approach,
yeah,
but it didn't sound like a bar band.
That's interesting. One of the reasons I chose to do this for Avi's birthday feature was because I was hoping it would delve more into the production side. I've been trying little by little to learn more about the production end of music, and just every little thing I learn is so intriguing. I'm like hyper fixated on music production right now, and I love it because there's so much that goes into it. It's so much beyond the actual writing the song, performing the song, recording the song. It's just so many detailed layers of things to be done and so many people involved with it, and it's just insane.
Ever.
And it had this like darkness, like this wideness to it.
Darkness,
that just thing. Like it was rock and roll but with like roots.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, but roots in like classical music.
Yeah, absolutely.
All is well. Heaven, hell, wherever I go, all is well with my soul.
I just remember us having a bite and then going back to my place, and then us being on my back porch looking out at the forest, and I brought the speaker out and we just started trading music and like going back and forth between like just things that we really, really loved, and then things that we felt would work for the album. And it just felt like both of our musical worlds expanded in that moment.
It's ironic. I don't know if this is like a big thing with musicians when they meet someone else who's in music and start talking about collaborating, but that story reminds me so much, because a lot of you probably know I'm a huge Home Free fan. The story of how Tim and Austin spent an entire night on a cruise ship where Austin was at the time performing, and the rest of Home Free was on there performing, but separately. And they just spent an entire night in Tim's cabin going back and forth over different a cappella songs and, like, totally geeking out over music. And I can definitely see how that would be a very common thing in the music industry, but I don't know if that's more at this down-to-earth level that they and Avi are both kind of on, or if it's a lot more widespread. Either way, it's always so sweet to hear about something like that, because it's just, you can picture it in your head and really, like, get a sense of the personality. And yeah.
We kind of skipped the, like, getting to know each other, because instantly we felt like we just loved music and were in, like, in the moments. Like, oh, there's a song in my rabbit hole that's like this. And he was like, oh, there's a song in my rabbit hole like this.
My eyes can finally see.
At that first meeting at his house, we said the Western, like, we were going Ennio Morricone. That was something we were wanting to achieve. Like, we were wanting to do something progressive and modern in its own, like, spirit and low end and tribalness.
Yeah.
But we wanted to preserve this kind of Western soundtracky kind of vibe. Mm-hmm.
Very
mysterious. Cinematic. Yeah.
Yeah.
Very, very mysterious. It was he and I coming from our worlds and meeting in that place,
mm-hmm.
you know, and building outward from
yeah.
that place. And that,
from the songs that I've heard out of the ones they're talking about, because I did a few of his that were still only lyric videos, and yeah, those pictures that were taken, they really do kind of embody the feel of the song. And it wouldn't at all be surprising to just see a tumbleweed go by. And it's just a very unique sound and a beautiful sound. And to know that that was such a big collaboration and a group effort is just I'm having trouble putting my words together today, apparently.
That was definitely the cool thing.
Fire in my eyes, I made you cry. Filled up all the oceans and swallowed all my pride, and it sunk to the bottom of the sea. Yeah, it rose with my pride and Andy, and I know I wasn't right. Don't be mistaken, I'll tell the truth when I...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there were a couple of song clips in there that I didn't recognize. And I know it's been a while since I did some of Avi's stuff, so I'm really looking forward to delving deeper during this birthday feature. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I will see you back for parts 2 through 5 of this birthday feature. I'm going back to a lot of his early solo stuff. Well, I say solo, what I mean by that is after he left Pentatonix. So I've got one solo and three Avriel and the Sequoias. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. I hope to see you guys back, and I'll see you in the next one.